In this problem, we're looking at a simple pendulum that starts from some known initial angle. We're given the length of the string on this, we're given the mass of the pendulum bob, and in part A, we want to get the speed at the lowest point, and in part B, we want to get the tension in the string at that lowest point. So we need to recognize part A as an energy conservation problem. I have a drop in height for this pendulum, and we're going to say that the final height of the pendulum is zero, and then we'll call the initial height y. And then the main trick of the problem is how do we express that y in terms of all the parameters of the problem? Well, this is a pretty standard trick for pendulum problems. I recognize that I've built a right triangle just by drawing that horizontal at the initial height. And the adjacent side to that 35 degree angle is given by the hypotenuse times the cosine of the angle. So that leg is 1.1 cosine 35. Then I realize that the distance from the attachment point all the way down to the pendulum bob in its lowest state, that's simply the length of the string, or 1.1 meters. And that means my initial height y is simply the difference, 1.1 minus 1.1 cosine 35. Now that we have that initial height, we can apply energy conservation to figure out the speed at the lowest point. So we have a simple conversion from gravitational potential energy, that's mgy, to kinetic energy, 1/2 mv squared. The masses cancel out of that, and we multiply both sides by 2 and square root the result, and we get the familiar solution, v equals square root 2gy. Plugging in g and y, we get the square root of 2 times 9.8 times the quantity 1.1 minus 1.1 cosine 35. And when we run the numbers on this, we get a speed of 1.97 meters per second. Now in part B, we want the tension in the string at that lowest point. So this requires a quick force analysis. And of course we have gravity pulling down, and then we have the tension in the string pulling up. So there's the force of gravity pulling down that has a magnitude of mg, and then the tension in the string pulling up with a magnitude of t. Now the reason I made t bigger in the diagram is because I know the acceleration of the pendulum bob is toward the center of curvature here. And that means the net force must point toward the center of curvature, so t must be bigger than mg. So we apply Newton's second law to the pendulum bob at this moment. That's F net equals ma, and we're going to use a coordinate system where upward is positive. So t counts as positive, mg counts as negative. There's my net force, that's equal to mass times acceleration. Well, it's in circular motion here, so the acceleration is v squared over r. And the radius of curvature r is equal to the length of the string here. So we solve for the tension, we add mg to both sides, and I'm gonna factor out an m on the right-hand side as we go. So I get m times the quantity g plus v squared over r. Now we just have to plug in the numbers, and my mass is 275 grams or 0.275 kilograms, g is 9.8, v is 1.97, we found it in part A. I've got to square that and then divide by r, which is 1.1. And when I run the numbers on this, I get a tension of 3.67 newtons. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.